Many students lose marks in their mathematics exams because of poor exam strategy. Let me help you perform better by sharing 7 winning principles with you. G'day. Welcome to Crystal Clear Mathematics, where it is easier than you think. I'm your host, Graeme Henderson. Over the years, I've seen many students lose marks because of poor time management or poor planning during their mathematics exams. If you suffer from similar problems, then here are 7 practical things that you can do during your exams to help you earn the best results that you can. First, spend time calming yourself and relaxing before the exam even begins. While you're seated there at your desk, close your eyes, stretch gently, breathe deeply, and rest. There are many good websites containing advice on relaxation techniques. Read them carefully and adopt the methods that work for you. Second, calculate how long you have to earn each mark. Normally, you'll be told the length of an exam and how many marks are allocated before the day that you sit for it. But even if a test is given to you suddenly, it's worth spending a few moments calculating this figure. Knowing this information can help you avoid spending too long on any particular question. In my country, most major exams seem to be based on 1.5 minutes per mark. This means that if you encounter a 3-mark question, you should allocate no more than 4.5 minutes to answering the question. Third, during your reading time before the exam even starts, or during the first minute or so of your exam, take time to scan through your paper and look for questions that you can answer confidently. Don't worry too much about questions that look difficult. They will be there whether or not you worry, and you will in fact be able to solve them more easily later in the exam. For the moment, your task is to find the questions that you can solve easily and to form a plan in your mind of the order in which you will answer them when you're allowed to start writing. Fourth, when the exam starts, spend at least the first 20 or 30 minutes answering those questions that you have already identified as easy. This is a time when your stress levels can reduce dramatically, so it should be a calming time. Do not attempt to answer a question that is difficult or confusing for you. If you encounter a question that proves to be more difficult than you first anticipated, simply abandon it and make a note to come back to it later. Your primary objective during this first 20 or 30 minutes is to work swiftly and efficiently and with as little stress as possible. This will allow 2 very important things to happen. First, the stress response in your body and the stress hormones in your blood should diminish markedly. This will allow your mind to think more clearly during the remainder of the exam when you're attempting the more difficult questions. And this means that you should be able to answer them more easily. Second, you should find that you've raced through a significant part of your exam paper with a very high success rate. For example, after 30 minutes of a 1-hour exam, you may find that you've already completed 60 or 65% of the exam paper and already earned 50 or even 60% of the marks. It's a very comforting feeling to feel that you've earned 50% by half time. And this allows you to relax even more and potentially perform better in the second half of your paper. Fifth, do not get bogged down on any particular question. If you've already invested more time on a question than the marks would warrant, it's time to leave it and go to other questions and return later on. Make a code to keep track of the questions that you leave and return to. Some students will circle the question number when they have to leave and will shade it in when they answer the question successfully later on. It is senseless spending time on a difficult question when you could be earning marks on other questions elsewhere in the paper. Sixth, if there is a multiple choice section in your exam paper, consider answering it last, or at least after you've earned as many marks as possible from the longer section of the paper. The great advantage of multiple choice questions, of course, is that if you're running out of time, you stand a much higher chance of guessing the answer correctly. As you work through your multiple choice section, watch the clock and still only allocate the required amount of time per question. If you find you're running out of time, mark the question as incomplete and go on to other questions and return to that one when you have time. If you've been able to eliminate one or two of the options, then cross them off from the question sheet. It means that when you return to that question, you have less work to do, and if you have to guess, your success rate is going to be higher. Make it a habit of working right through your multiple choice section, answering the easy questions first before you return to attempt all the more difficult ones. It's a good idea to ask for some spare paper and to set your work out as you answer multiple choice questions. I have seen many students lose lots of marks carelessly because they've tried to answer multiple choice questions in their head. Finally, it's a good idea to answer multiple choice questions if you can before you get too distracted by the options given. Seventh, if you finish with time to spare, it's a good idea to shut your eyes, breathe deeply, and stretch your arms and legs out in front of you, never sideways or upwards in an exam room, and to take time to rest and relax a little before you go back to check your results. When you review questions, it's a good idea to try to answer them in a different way to see if you get the same answer, or to review your answers to see whether they fully satisfy the conditions of the question. There is no merit in walking out of an exam room early only to realise that there were questions you could have answered better. Checking is a very good policy. This is Graham Henderson, hoping that these strategies will help you earn all the marks that you deserve in your mathematics exams and help you avoid losing marks because of stress or poor planning. Please subscribe to my channel and like and comment on this video. Thank you.